So we would like to better understand how parasites, a variety of different parasites, affect moose survival, particularly calves through the winter time, and use that data to inform management strategies for the long-term persistence of moose, but also kind of get a sense of perceptions by stakeholders on how they view the risk of moose and try to use that information together to better inform management strategies.
How will you be proceeding with this study? Are you out in the field? It sounds like students are involved in this.
Yeah, so we are primarily in the lab. So as I said before, we're working with Maine Department of Inland Fisheries and Wildlife, who's doing the field component, but I will have a couple graduate students on this team who will be hopefully in both in the field and in the lab, collecting data on parasites and infection of a bacteria in these particular moose.
It sounds like ultimately part of this is determining, I read a quote, survival model, determining a survival model for these animals. In your mind, I mean, obviously the study hasn't quite started yet, but do you believe that there is a way to sort of save and protect these animals out in the wild from these parasites?
That is a really good question. And that's something that requires a little more thought into what are the actual strategies you can use if you know that moose are threatened by parasites. How can you use that information to modify certain management protocols? And I think that is something that we still have to think a lot more through. I'm not exactly sure of the potential options at this point, but these are part of the goals of the study is to get sense from also from managers as well as what are some potential options.
Going into this study, I know the last time we spoke with Lee, he sort of walked us through how many moose were affected and how many ticks they find on these moose out there. And I remember just hearing some of those numbers. It was shocking almost. Mm-hmm. Are there things that are standing out to you right now about, you know, some of the data that you're about to look at?
Yeah, so one of the focus of our work particularly is trying to understand not just how the winter tick affect survival, but how particular infections that also basically attack the blood cells of moose who are already being depleted of all their blood through winter ticks, like feeding on them and sucking them their blood dry, basically. So then trying to imagine like the compounding effects of some other parasites. And we have found that in previous work that there are other parasites that are infecting blood cells of some of these moose that could be exacerbating the issue.
Let me ask you this. It sounds like it's believed there are between 60 and 70,000 moose in Maine. How important is this study?
So this study is really important for understanding if there are going to potentially be population crashes or declines in the future due to the impact of ticks on calves specifically. So calves are the ones that are not surviving through the winter due to these infestations. And so right now the population seems to be doing really well, but if we think about projecting that into the future, understanding what the short-term impact is, it can help us predict into the future if that's a concern. I think one thing with our team is that it's a really interdisciplinary, and we're trying to take this like one health approach and understand from the social science aspect and combine it with some of the biological knowledge that we're gaining to actually make on the ground management like actions that can be effective. And so that's sort of a bigger goal of this study is trying to combine these different disciplines to have more of an impact.